Om Shri Mahaganapataye Namaha, Om Narayanaya Namaha. Today, I would just tell about the Angan, that is Karan Nyasam. Nyasam means establishing. You are firmly putting Bhagavan through your hands and through and establish him in your parts of your body. So it's very important for this, and I will tell the procedures which for which mantra. That is, it starts from the Purva Nyasam only. Asya Sri Vishnur Divya Sasanama Stotra. So that it starts from there. So it goes like this. So Asya Sri Vishnur, this the Mahamantra, for this Mahamantra, the Rishihi is Veda Vyasar only. Vyasa Rishihi only. See, I told you, when we do the Sandhyavandana Mantra, all the Rishis are established in our Shiras, in our head region, because they give jnanam, intelligence to us, they educate us. Then all the swaras, sapta chandas, I told you, bhuradi, sapta, vyasrinam, atri, brisi, all the rishis go there in the head. All the swaras, chandas, sapta chandas will go into our, actually we have to close our mouth and touch on the top lip. After closing the mouth, you have to touch on the top lip. But sometimes you may touch your saliva, so it may get, it may not be shuddha. So it's better to touch our nose area. That's what my gurus have taught me. In the prana, because from the prana only you sing the song. For song you take a deep breath and you sing. So, and then all the devas, rishis, gods, everybody come in our chest area. So I will start with, so the Bhagavan Veda Vyasa Rishihi, you can take your right hand and then you can bring together all the five fingers, group it, and then place it on the top of your head, on the central point of your head, by saying this, when you say this mantra, Asya Sri Vishnur Divya Sahasranama Stotrasya Veda Vyaso Bhagavan Rishihi. So when you say Veda Vyaso Bhagavan Rishihi, take your hand and place it, as I told you, on the top of the head. Anushtup Chandaha, you can keep it on the, you tell this mantra, take your right hand, place it on the top of your lip or on your nose. But you have to tell this mantra, Anushtup Chandaha. Sri Mahavishnu Paramatma Sriman Narayano Devata. Now you take both your right hand and the left hand. You group together your 5 + 5, 10 fingers. Place it on the center of your heart. You tell this mantra and place it there. Amrudam Shudbhavo Bhanur Iti Bijam. So the Bijam is a seed from the Nabhi. You have to take your right hand, chant this sentence. Amrudam Shudbhavo Bhanur Iti Bijam. Take, group all your five fingers. For all these mantras, you have to group all your five fingers to a same connect, to the same point. Group it. We are doing that in our customs. And then place it in your nabhi, the navel. From there, Brahma came in the Padmam. So keep it there. Right hand only. Devagi Nandana Srishtedi Shaktihi. Now, again with the right hand, you group all your fingers and place it on top of your right hand, below the shoulder area. Just when you say Trivikrama, Vamana and all in Sandhyavandana, you keep there. So on your right hand, below the 4 inches, say below the shoulder, you group your five fingers, saying this mantra, that Devagi Nandanaha Srishteti Shaktihi. You place it there. Then Udbhavaha Chobhano Deva Iti Paramo Mantraha. Now, Paramo Mantraha. So you have to bring both the hands, the right hand and the left hand, grouping the 5 + 5, 10 fingers, 5 fingers independently and respectively, and then bring both the hands, place it in your center of your chest, chant this, tell this shloka, Udbhavaha Chobhano Deva Iti Paramo Mantraha. Shangabrin Nandaki Chakri Iti Kilaka. Shanga, I told you, conch and Nandaki is the sword of Mahavishnu, the sword, the fighting sword. Chakri is the chakra, the Sudarshana chakra. So, again take your right hand. But now, you place the five fingers of your right hand, grouping together, in your left hand side hand, left side hand, left hand, same place below the shoulder. 4 inches, say for example, below the shoulder area. Just like you do Trivikrama, Vamana, Sridhara, Rishikesha. You do Sridhara, Rishikesha, no? With the central finger in the top. Same way, five fingers together. So, Shangabrin Nandagi is on the left, Iti Kilagam. Then, Sharga Danva Gadadara. I told you what is Sharga, it's a sharp horn of any animal like an elephant also. and dhanva with that dhanu bow gada gada you know is a base. I have told you the meanings. So sharanga dhanva gada daraha, one who wears that, so with that chanting that mantra ityastram, so this astram is bow, is arrows, sorry, is arrows are like that. So you chant this mantra sharanga dhanva gada dara ityastram. You after chanting it, again take your right hand only, grouping your five fingers, and place it on your left hand below the shoulder area, 4 inches. Just like your right shoulder, you have to place in the same spot in your left shoulder. And then, Shangabrun Nandagi Shakri Tikilagam, like that you do. Then, Sharanga Dhanva Gadadara Astram. Now, this mantra, you have placed on the right and the left. The left side is Shangabrun Nandagi Shakri Tikilagam. Now, Sharanga Dhanva Gadadara, what you have to do, again take your right hand, group your five fingers, and then you have to do like something like Om Bhor Bhuvasva around your head. You have to bring your hand, grouping your five fingers. Just like when you do some tarpana, you put your tarpana, this from the Panchava Udrani, you pour the water and then you do the prokshana around your head. Same way, because this is for the gadha and his arrows and his bow and all, it flies in all directions. It will protect you from all directions. So that's why it is, you have to do the prokshana, the circumambulation around your head with your right hand, five fingers grouped together. Okay. And Radhangabani Rakshobhya Iti Netram. Netram means eyes. So probably Ratha means, I have told you, it's a chariot. Radha Angam means the reins. Any part of a chariot, anything is called Anga in Sanskrit, part. And Rakshobhya means Rakshaha, it protects. So for this you have to, Netram means you have to touch your eyes, two eyes, probably two wheels. In a chariot, olden days chariot, without a chariot means two wheels only. They don't have four wheels. So two wheels. And then you can place it in your, close your eyes and place your right hand, grouping your five fingers together. Everywhere you have to take your right hand in all these places. And in some places when you tell for chest, you have to take both the hands. Trisama samaga sameti kavacham. Now you have to use both your right hand and the left hand. And your left hand will run across your chest and go to the right shoulder area. And your right hand will go across your chest over the left hand, and it will be placed on the left hand side shoulder area below, hand area below the shoulder, same place. It will be like a multiplication sign. You must have seen some in the army, old soldiers will keep their two swords crossed and the shield on top of it. Exactly both your hands will be crossing one on top of the each other. Your right hand will go to the left shoulder, your left hand will go to the right shoulder, crossing on top of each other, and that is your kavacham, that is your armor. It armor across your chest area. It protects you. So, trisama samaga sameti kavacham. Kavacham is the armor. Now, rutuh sudarshanaha kala digbandaha. So, you should not get, Swami, Bhagavan, is in all directions, is a sudarshanah. Su means mangalam, complete mangalam, darshanam. Darshana means his sight, vision, his presence, whatever you want to say. When you see him only, he is protecting you, he is tying all the dishas. Dig means directions, disai in Tamil. So, now what you do, you have to take both of your hands, bring it to each other like namaste when you say, and stating this line, shloka, you can say, Rutu Sudarshana Kala Iti Digbandaha. So you bring your two hands together like a namaste and say this mantra, that's all. And Sri Vishwa Rupa Iti Dhyanam. So after doing this, both the hands together, you meditate on this Vishwa Rupa. That is, you meditate on Om or Narayana. If you say Narayana, it is enough. Sri Rama, Om. You have a thought on him, that is all it says. That will be the meditation point for you. Is Vishwarupam. You can't see his Vishwarupam so easily, but he may reveal to you if you are in a deep meditation. But this is the science behind this. Now, why we do this? In cosmos, in the universe, there are a lot of energies, absolute energies. It's potential energy is there, you know, at the smallest point you can generate another universe also. So much of energies, some energies are may not be good, like gravity or the dark energies or the black spots in the universe, the black holes. So we want divine energies. Our ancient rishis have found. So when you do this Karanyasam or Anganyasam, just like you are inviting energies from the cosmos into the world, you are inviting sunlight, one energy is coming, moonlight, one energy is coming, storm, maruts, one energies may come from outside the universe, vacuum energy may be coming. A lot of energies are there. You establish a line of contact by your mobile phone to your son in America, for example. So you are establishing a contact with various energies. You are drawing these energies. You are like a vacuum, like you are pulling all these energies through bhakti. You are sucking all these energies like a vacuum, like a gravity from the cosmos and establishing in your sapta chakras. You have seven chakras, sahasrara, agya, vishuddha, anahata, manipura, swadhisthana, muladhara. These chakras you are energizing by Bhagavan. Bhagavan places himself in your body. He is there in everywhere, but you are energizing through his bhakti and devotion, through your bhakti and devotion. So this Karanyasam and Anganyasam is very important. This was actually taught to us by Shri Anna professor, who was the head of Ramakrishna at Mailapur, Chennai. Used to teach this and has written a book in 68 when we were all studying in 70s and 72s. This was a procedure, maybe adopted in the North Indian side, but it is definitely adopted in the South Indian side. ओम दीर्घायुष्मान् भव दीर्घसुमंगली भव सर्वव्याधि निवारण प्राप्तिरस्तु सर्व ऐश्वर्यम् अभिवृद्धिर्भवतु सर्व मंगलानि भवन्तु तदास्तु तदास्तु तदास्तु